A picture of Barack Obama recently surfaced that might have sunk his chances of being president had we seen it sooner. And I think there's a lesson in that. It's a 2005 photograph taken at a Congressional Black Caucus meeting of a young Senator Obama before he decided to run for president. He's smiling with Nation of Islam leader Louis Farrakhan. The photographer, Askia Mohammed, says he did not make the picture public at the time because he believed it would have made a difference to Obama's political future. Even after Obama was nominated, elected, re-elected, the photo was kept under wraps. Mohammed finally decided to release it as part of a self-published book. It's important to remember, when Obama ran in 2008, opponents tried to paint him as a socialist, as a left-wing radical. And to be sure, he'd associated with some of the latter. During the campaign, intense focus was brought to Obama's friendship with Bill Ayers, a co-founder of the Weather Underground, a revolutionary group founded in 1969 that bombed numerous public buildings. And Reverend Jeremiah Wright, who Obama had known since the 80s, the two became close enough that Wright ended up officiating the Obama's wedding, and the Reverend inspired Obama so much that the audacity of hope was based on one of Wright's sermons. But Wright also said some notoriously anti-American things in the wake of the September 11 attacks. And in March of 2008, ABC ran an article detailing all of Wright's controversial sermons. Obama repeatedly had to distance himself, and finally, with his nomination perhaps on the line, he gave a major address on race at the National Constitution Center. I was in the room that day when Obama declared that Wright's comments were only divisive and destructive. And he also added, when Wright suggests that Minister Farrakhan somehow represents one of the greatest voices of the 20th and 21st century, then there are no excuses. Well, just imagine if this photo of Obama and Farrakhan appeared soon after that quote. Farrakhan is toxic to a large swath of America due to his anti-Semitism and black separatism. He's a man with a history of controversial statements. Maybe his most cringeworthy, though, was about Jewish people in 1985 at Madison Square Garden, where he said, "You cannot say never again to God, because when he puts you in the oven, never again don't mean a damn thing." In combination with a photo of Farrakhan, Senator Obama's relationship with Ayers and Reverend Wright could have looked all the more damning. The case for his radicalism would have been that much stronger, not just in the right-wing media, but in the center and on the left, too. Fear of a radical president could have prevented an Obama White House. But here's the kicker. As president, Obama was no radical. If anything, he was a left-of-center moderate. Domestically, Obama was a mixed bag. His trademark legislation, the Affordable Care Act, was a policy idea created by the very conservative Heritage Foundation. For those who thought Obama might be a closet socialist, he surely disappointed when he refused to prosecute any of the major figures from the 2008 financial crash. He also stacked his deficit commission with fiscal conservatives. Meanwhile, President Obama was the biggest proponent to date of free market thinking in education, using his Department of Education to encourage and fund charters across the country. He went so far as to violate Pakistan's sovereignty in order to kill Osama bin Laden. President Obama may not have favored the words radical Islam, but he significantly increased President George W. Bush's drone attacks in the war against terror. And he never did close Gitmo. The list could go on and on. Obama didn't violate gun rights the way that conservatives feared. And he was the deportation president on immigration. By Nate Silver's measure, this political record made him a completely middle-of-the-road Democrat. DW Nominate went one step further. The group estimated that Obama was actually the least liberal Democratic president since 1945. Now, one can debate whether Obama was a true centrist or whether he was a standard left-of-center Democrat, but radical, he was not. And maybe this is what they mean when they say a picture is worth a thousand words.